privilege to be the long-standing president of the Jamaican FA, Captain Horace Burrell. Exciting times. We're on the verge of the World Cup here in Brazil. Both Jamaica and Trinidad and Tobago have continued to develop. Obviously, results have not gone in our favor, but again, the experience is what matters right now.
Well, very interesting time, Sean, and I'm very pleased to see how things are going in the football. And when you look at our finances, for example, you'll be very pleased because we have indeed seen a marked improvement in this regard. And, you know, we're also having so many and several courses being put on by the CONCACAF, various countries, member associations. And I believe that things are moving, you know, in the right direction.
Perfect. What are your feelings with your CONCACAF hat on now about Trinidad and Tobago being able to pull off a friendly against the likes of Argentina and Iran just mere days before a World Cup and being able to hold their own to some extent?
Well, I've always said, you know, that there is no shortage of talent in the Caribbean. And, you know, Jamaica and Trinidad are the leaders. And, you know, we continue, unfortunately, not to qualify for the main tournaments. But we have always shown, you know, good promise, so to speak. And in particular, I was very pleased when both Trinidad and Jamaica got an opportunity to participate in the pre-World Cup qualifying games with the countries who already qualified for the World Cup. Trinidad having gone down to Argentina and having played there, certainly, having left with a scoreline of two or three, you know, that was commendable, because whenever you play a squad that is preparing for a particular tournament, all relaxed and ready, then you're always not going to do as well, because it's like going up against a well-oiled machine. So congratulations to them. I'm sure it will go a very far way in helping them to prepare for the upcoming Caribbean Cup and also for the Gold Cup and beyond. So again, congrats to the Trinidad delegation, who did fairly well, and again, who keep the flag of the Caribbean flying.
Fans back home in Jamaica, obviously, they would have been a little bit concerned with that last result. How do you intend to now work on that and improve from here on?
Well, let me tell you, it was a very, very, very disappointing result. You go and you get beaten by 8-0. That is awful, to say the least. There's absolutely no excuse for that kind of performance. I mean, people are saying that the goalkeeper, you know, failed to perform, but it has to be a little bit more than that. Again, we're coming off four-game tour, which we had some very tough games. But again, I am not going to find any excuses to have been beaten by that margin, that wide margin. It's unacceptable at this level. And therefore, I am sure that what it shows is some players are not able to take it to the next level, you know, and therefore that will, you know, give the coach an idea as to some of the players who can continue at the national level. Maybe at the local level they do fairly well, but at the international level they're just not cutting it. And so I'm sure the experienced coach that we have, Coach Schaefer, will do the necessary, you know, adjustments. Because you can't tell me that just days before we played against a tough team from Egypt and got a 2-2 ending result, and then days after you're going to be beaten by such a wide margin. Embarrassing, to say the least, but at the same time, we also have to remember that we went up against France, who had been, you know, preparing for such a long time, for many weeks. They have world-class players. But I will say again, the margin of victory earned by France is not acceptable, should never have been. And, you know, we will certainly try not to repeat that.
On that note, now obviously still looking forward to a very exciting Caribbean Cup finals in Montego Bay later this year.
It is going to be very, very exciting. It's not going to be easy for any of the teams, because everybody is going to be coming with the winner advancing to the, you know, Cup of America, I mean, in 2016, where they're going to be playing against teams out of South America. That prize is a huge one, and I think that that is going to be the catalyst to drive the players into giving their best performance. And therefore, I am very confident that it will be a very interesting series in Montego Bay, where we've decided to play this. And you know, let's see what happens. But I expect Trinidad, I expect you know, all the other Caribbean teams, Cuba, you know, Haiti, and all the participants to be very, very competitive.
Perfect. Thank you so much.